evolution is a fantasy, but that is exactly what I am telling you. As a world...
Where's your sidekick, Taggart? 6 months ago, Seraph Industries was attacked by mercenaries whose objective was to cripple our research. But I've learned the attack was just a smokescreen. Megan Reed's team was kidnapped, and Isaiah Sandoval, your personal aide, was involved.
That is ridiculous. Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize for Mr. Jensen's intrusion, and I assure you that these accusations are without basis.
Are they?
This is Sandoval. Why are you calling me here?
There's been a change of plans. Seraph's team must not make it to the hearing.
But that's too soon. If you want me to remove the GPLs, I'll need a full operating suite. Does the facility have one?
That's your man, Taggart. Talking about removing implanted GPL devices so that the people who took Seraph's scientists could cover it up.
I see what's going on here. Seraph Industries has received two black eyes in the last few days. The first due to the shocking news coming out of Montreal that biotech companies are secretly participating in unethical super soldier experiments. And the second as a result of their violent escalation of today's peaceful protest. David Seraph and his corporate bedfellows are desperate and in imminent danger of losing the regulation vote, so this man has been sent here to attack my reputation.
I'm right here, Taggart. Look at me. I admit, I wouldn't feel bad if your reputation was damaged in front of the press, since you've been doing the same to my colleagues for years, but that's not why I'm here. Seraph scientists are alive, and it's time for the truth to come out.
The truth, Mr. Jensen, is that this recording of yours proves nothing. It could have been made by anyone in the world with a grudge against Humanity Front, and you are our prime suspect.
You're right, it's not enough to get a conviction. But it's enough for a search warrant. It's all I want, Taggart. Why are you standing in the way?
I'm not. I'm trying to protect... Look, Mr. Jensen. I know why you came here instead of taking your recording to the police. I know the real reason for your accusations, and you're not entirely to blame for what you're doing. It is common, after trauma such as the one you suffered, to fixate on the event, to stay blocked in the past. In a word, you're obsessed.
The reason I'm obsessed with the past, Taggart, is that there are still five people missing and their attackers haven't paid for what they did. Your refusal to help me is getting in the way of justice.
Now, really? Are you in any position to see clearly enough to recognize justice? You're lashing out. You've cast me as your enemy, and you're hoping that by falsely accusing me, by diminishing me, you'll regain the sense of control you lost when someone else ripped your life apart 6 months ago.
Of course I want control. Every time I touch something, I wonder, just for a second, every time, if what I'm feeling is real. It's a bit like being in charge of an organization, I bet. Do you always know what the people at Humanity Front, your people, are doing?
Of course not. Well, that is to say, I don't need to. From the very day I founded Humanity Front, I made it clear that the group would be devoted to non-violent resistance. To deviate from this would mean dishonoring the memory of the very woman whose murder caused me to found the organization. Mr. Jensen, how can you possibly accuse me of doing otherwise?
What happened to your wife was tragic. But what's happening to Seraph scientists is going on right now, and you have a chance to do something about it. You have nothing to lose if Sandoval's innocent. And if he isn't, you can preserve your reputation by helping me. Why won't you do that?
Because I just can't believe Isaias would be guilty of this, but you're right. Whether he's guilty or not, I have to get to the truth. Marjorie would want it that way. Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize, but I'm going to have to beg your indulgence for a few moments more. If you'll all please remain patient, I will return as soon as I can. Thank you. Mr. Jensen, I'll see you backstage. Mr. Jensen, I appreciate you allowing me to deal with this in a more discreet manner.
Save it, Taggart. You've wasted enough of my time as it is. Now, where's Sandoval?
He has an apartment he uses when in this city, on Grand River Road. He mentioned he was feeling very run down, so I can only assume he went there.
I see.
He's not an evil man, Mr. Jensen. If he's done what you say, it's only because of his brother, Ezekiel. A man you might know better as Zeke Sanders.
Sanders? The man who attacked Sarah's manufacturing plant?
I knew nothing about it until after it was over, and then I tried. I tried to convince Isaias not to follow in his footsteps.
Good job.
Mr. Jensen, please. Isaias has done so much for so many needy people. People suffering from implant rejection. Promise me you will deal with him fairly.
That all depends on Isaias.
I understand, but please try.
Detroit, Toronto, Mumbai, and Rio de Janeiro all report violent clashes taking place outside the doors of such well-known biotechnology firms as Kusanagi.
Access granted.
Patch me through. Jensen? I almost didn't recognize you. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, what are the chances? Do you remember me? I was a rookie when you still rolled in SWAT.
Nikki, of course I remember you. How you been? The brass got you on riot control too?
Yeah, I am. Or I was until... Damn it. Look, something big is going down, and I'm kind of freaking out here. You remember that MCB-er, Jacob White? You busted him a couple of times.
Yeah, I remember him. Assault and possession. He's still running rackets?
No, I mean, yeah, shit, I don't know. Anyway, it doesn't matter, because he's moved on to bigger things.
Nikki, slow down.
Listen, hear me out. I just got word he has his hands on some real military-grade explosives. The prick's got a fucking bomb, Adam. And you know how much he hates the PD. He's going to hit us while we have our pants down with the riots. You gotta help us out here.
Nikki, I'm kind of busy. If he's got a bomb, just call it in and follow procedure.
What do you think I've been doing? I've been on the horn all night, and my CO already sent a patrol over to Jacob's house. We've got a warrant, so they searched the place, but nothing came up, not even Jacob. Now they're saying my CI is probably full of shit and just fucking with me. Bullshit! Jacob's using the riots as cover, and he's going to hit us, and hit us hard. Adam, I need you to trust me on this. You gotta help me find Jacob.
Fine. I'll help. Let's go over what we know. Just the facts.
What we know? Just the facts? What we know is he's certified batshit crazy. Hates cops, quotes Che Guevara, and got his hands on military-grade explosives. What more do you need to know? Oh, Christ, man. I've got nobody to help me, and I can't even breathe. How am I supposed to find this guy? The bomb could be right under us, right now!
Nikki, relax. Keep it together.
I'm trying, Adam. I don't think I'm cut out for this kind of stuff. People could die. We could die.
Just focus, okay? We know that White hates cops, so his first target is probably gonna be the precinct or somewhere nearby. Make sense?
Yeah, okay. But it could be anywhere. He wouldn't risk going to the precinct. Too many people would recognize him. That leaves the transit station, the sewers, and the alleys around the precinct. Look, I need to stay here and report any leads to my CO. Can you check those locations for Jacob or his bomb?
Got it.
I know it's a long shot, but I'm hoping we get backup to expand the search. In the meantime, we can check those areas, and who knows, maybe we'll catch a break. Oh, and Jensen, please don't turn him into a martyr. I'd prefer him breathing.
Okay, sweetheart?
I'm a little shaken up, but I'm just packaging
off. Training exercises for augmented soldiers? How did they think this was gonna go over?
It's almost too late. The city burns down around your ears. And you do nothing.
You wait for them to save you?
I promise you, you learn to fear the machine men. They're among us. In plain sight. And their masters mold the way we think. They spew their poison into your ears if you listen.
Access granted.
You can no longer tell the difference between the truth and their lies. There's no shelter. It will find you! There's a sickness coming, my children. Gray and deadly. It will come. Kings, and we will bow to them. Then it will be too late! Open your eyes, my friends. You've been blind for too long. Stand at the edge of an abyss.
Access granted.
questions as best we can, but don't get your panties in a bunch if you get hung up.
Sorry, I can't let you into the station at this time.
But one of those hooligans stole my purse!
Sure you closed the door?
Yeah. Of course I did. What do you think I am? An idiot?
You're not gonna make me answer that, are you?
Sounds like something moving around.
Thank you.
Pritchard, looks like Sandoval's got a secret bunker. I'm gonna flush him out.
Let's hope he's still there.
You're going down!
Access granted. Access granted.
And this is why I urge every member of my staff, every man and woman dedicated to the true mission of the Humanity Front, to do the same. Isaias, if you're watching this, I beg you, do not allow misplaced anger to destroy everything we have struggled to achieve.
It's over. He knows I can't come back from that.
Everybody knows, Sandoval. You can't hide from what you've done.
What I've done, Mr. Jensen? I spent years patching people back together from augmentation botched jobs and systemic organ rejection brought on by implants. And now, because of Bill's betrayal, I'll never practice medicine again.
You really want to help someone? Tell me where Seraph's scientists are.
I wish I could, Mr. Jensen. But my involvement ended right after I failed to remove their GPLs.
You failed?
Turns out, my surgical skills weren't good enough to bypass David Seraph's insurance policy. So for all I know, those little implants are broadcasting right now. On a frequency so low, your network specialist wouldn't think to look for it.
You changed the frequencies.
You have your answers, Mr. Jensen. And I've lost all of mine. The courts may think I have much to atone for, but my court will be a higher one.
How about I take that gun with me when I go?
You got everything you came for. Please, just leave.
Believe it or not, I'd rather you didn't kill yourself.
That's because you have no idea what tortures I've endured. The guilt, the shame. I was told the scientists would be used to find a peaceful solution to the augmentation crisis. Instead, I was involved in kidnapping and murder. My life ended that night. It's time for me to go.
Think about it. Are you really in such a hurry to face that higher court of yours?
At least there are no lies before God. Did you see that abominable press conference? William Taggart all but accused me of terrorism. He claimed that all the violence committed in the name of our cause was the result of my influence.
So stay alive long enough to tell him your side of the story.
He already knows it isn't true. I trusted that man. For years I gave him loyal service and he betrayed me. He sacrificed my freedom and good name to save the reputation of his organization. It's no use fighting him. He'll just spin it again. At least if I die, he'll never be able to use me again.
So tell your side of the story to the press. Swear at your trial that you're a better person than him. You want a peaceful solution to the augmentation crisis? Every camera in the country is going to be pointed at you. Use it to make a case. Convince people.
Bill Taggart already controls public opinion. You can try to lift my spirit all you want, Mr. Jensen, but the facts don't change. To think I believe that my life could be spent helping people. What foolish arrogance. I was a failure as a doctor and as a political lobbyist, but I didn't learn my lesson. I had to try one last time. I had to go too far. I should have known better. But I was a born loser, Mr. Jensen. And I am fated to die as one.
I hear what you're saying. You care too much. I know what that's like. Too well. Because I've been there. You want to fix everything right away. You want it so much, you start trying too hard. Trust me, if you deal with the smaller, easier stuff first, the big things don't look so big.
I care too much. I try too hard. Your empathy would be touching if it wasn't so condescending. I just told you everything I touch ends in failure. Don't tell me you know what that's like! No one does.
Pritchard, get this. The GPLs are still transmitting. Sandoval switched them to a lower frequency.
But they could be broadcasting anywhere in the world. I don't have the type of equipment we'll need to find them.
It's our only lead, Pritchard. You have to do something.
I know. Listen. The riot's still blocking the street entrance. Head back to your apartment and Malik will fly you over. Maybe by the time you get here, I'll have figured out something.
Access granted.
Fuck them cops, man.
Yeah, they can't tell us to get off the streets. We own these blocks as much as they do.
They must have locked them all up.
Thousands of angry rioters took to the streets in several cities this evening after viewing controversial satellite footage uncovered. Establishing security system. See you soon, Jensen.
Nice detective work, Jensen. You ready to return to HQ?
Yeah. Let's hope Pritchard's found that frequency.
You said it. a message for you, Jensen, from Pritchard. He says he's not in the office.
Great. So what exactly am I supposed to do?
I don't know. He said you should check in with the boss.
I could just see the entire young all gathered around their TV screens.
Even if it was true that we were breeding a bunch of augmented soldiers and training them, what do they think stopping us from going home?
Sheriff?
David's just stepped out for a moment, Mr. Jensen. But do come in. I've been hoping to meet you.
Mr. Darrow, I'm surprised you even know who I am.
David speaks very highly of you. He says that when it comes to detective work, you are like a dog with a bone. Have you found your scientist yet?
What else did David tell you?
Over the years, plenty. But today I'm here as a friend and fellow scientist. Things are getting quite turbulent out there, wouldn't you agree? So many people drunk on revolution. The United Nations being urged to intervene. And all because of the technology I created.
Things have come a long way since then.
Haven't they? And now my old friend David wants me to lead us to the Promised Land. He's asked me to invite members of the UN to Panchaya to convince them we don't need industry regulation.
Your geoengineering project in the Arctic Ocean.
The installation couldn't have been built without the assistance of augmented workers. And when it's finished, my little hole in the ocean is going to stop global warming. A lovely photo op, wouldn't you say?
If it works.
You mean, if it doesn't kill us all?
Adam? You're back. Can I speak to you outside? Get to the helipad, son. You're going back to Hengsha Island. Frank tracked down one of the GPLs.
Only one? Is it?
Sevchenko's. But Adam, we had to call in a favor of the DOD to do it.
Meaning, the conspirators probably know I'm coming.
Access granted.
Boss said we're heading back to Hengsha?
Pritchard tracks Evchenko's GPL signal. If he's alive, there's a chance the rest of them are too.
That's a pretty big leap, Jensen.
We've been making big leaps for a while now.
Whatever you say. You ready to get going?
No time like the present. Let's get going.
Then hop in.
Bad news, spy boy.
Spy boy?
Hangzhou traffic control just revoked our clearance. We're being rerouted to another part of the city.
I don't like that. I suppose you can't just ignore them.
Yeah, right. Chinese government. I've got to comply.
Bravo Echo Echo 008, proceeding to designated coordinates. What the hell?
We've got a Sam lock on our tail.
Jensen, all systems are down. Hang on, we're going in hard. Jump, Jensen!
Malik, we've got company.
I know, but the bird took some damage. Gonna need to patch it up before I can go.
I'll stay and cover you.
Negative! You need to get away from here and find Dr. Savchenko. I'll be fine.
You'll be a sitting duck.
Maybe, maybe not. But this is your best chance to slip by them unnoticed, and you know it. So get out of here, Jensen.
Malik, you hurt.
Just a scratch, spy boy.